he's in the camera.
Not laughing at me.
There once was a man, very keen, very smart, who happened to have a carnival act. This man's profession was also his art, of which he had quite the knack. He happened to be the best juggler I'd ever seen. This juggler had a motto that he told me when I was a teen. It takes a mighty fine skill to keep things in the air, but just 'cause something drops doesn't mean it isn't there. Even the greatest juggler can drop a ball or two, but he always picks it up, and if he can, so can you. One day his carnival came to my town. I just couldn't wait to get through. Everyone gathered around his stage to see what this juggler could do. He started out small but finished it strong. I was clinging on every toss, and when he took his bow, I kept wondering how his road to choose juggling was crossed. It takes a mighty fine skill to keep things in the air, but just 'cause something drops doesn't mean it isn't there. Even the greatest juggler can drop a ball or two, but he always picks it up, and if he can, so can you. When the audience had left, 'twas I stood alone. When I asked when he had heard the juggler's call, he sat down on a stage and said in reminiscing tone, "It began when I was old as you are tall. Family and friends and school and jobs, I juggle these every day. But once I found my balance, a juggler is what I stay. Now whenever I feel troubled of the problems I must face, I think back on what that juggler has said. I take a good deep breath and I juggle them all the way, and I'll probably keep on juggling till I'm dead. It takes a mighty fine skill to keep things in the air, but just 'cause something drops doesn't mean it isn't there. Even the greatest juggler can drop a ball or two, but he always picks it up, and if he can, so can you. Kenesaw Mountain Landis was a bad mother trucker. He was 17 feet tall, he had 150 wives. He didn't do too much, except he saved the game of baseball. He put two and two together, and he noticed it was four. Now the treachery of Shoeless Joe can't hurt us anymore, and it'll always be remembered as Kenesaw Mountain Landis. Shoe fellow named Joe Jackson was a fielder for the Black Sox, and he always wore Black Sox, but he never wore no shoes. He was the nicest fellow, and he had a couple problems. 'Cause he drank a lot, he beat his wife, and he always acted rude. He still made some babies, and he copped an attitude. And the one man that he hated most was Kenesaw Mountain Landis. The mafia said, "Shoeless Joe, you should really run this show. You should be the guy who owns baseball. And all you really got to do help us make a buck or two. We'll bet on the other team. You'll lose the game, but make it seem like nothing could be further from the truth." Shoeless Joe did what they said. He dropped a couple fly balls, and he walked up to the pitcher, and he poked him in the eye. And in the seventh inning, with the Black Sox nearly beaten, there was someone who was watching from his blimp above the stands, cradling a rifle in his And in case you hadn't guessed yet, it was Kenesaw Mountain Landis. Kenesaw said, drop that glove, or I swear by God above, I'll make you regret playing baseball. Then Jewish Joe looked up and saw the silver apple gaping maw. Though no one had noticed yet, his underwear was getting wet. He peed himself in front of everyone. Jewish Joe was finished, but he couldn't quite admit it. So he raised his middle finger up above the other four. And Kenesaw took careful aim and fired a single bullet. And he shot that dirty finger off and dropped his trusty gun. And everybody in the stands knew that he had won. And today they still refer to him as Kenesaw Mountain Landis. Shoeless Joe quit baseball and became a famous pop star. And asked a musical question, is she really going out with him? He had a couple albums and a comeback in the 80s. But he never won a Grammy and he never was the same. And he never could be satisfied with critical acclaim. Cause the critics all confused him with the great Elvis Costello. Cause the critics all confused him with the great